Today we'll discuss about how PMD rule set can be prepared. So before going to start, I wanna give two lines of definition for PMD. PMD is an open source. This will have a set of rules which we can identify in our coding standards. For example, if we have a multiple applications, so how coding standards can be identified? So manual processes is very lengthy until we have a very minimal code. Otherwise, it is difficult to identify coding standards. But we have a plugin called PMD where it can be check whatever applications we have. Only thing is we have to plug in PMD in Maven, and that Maven will take care about our coding standards. So basically, each and every person will have a different set of thinking, and they will they have in a mind like something cannot be it's not a correct rule. So someone will think other rule is correct. So if they want to customize the rules, so PMD have a many rules, and if they wanted to customize what rules can be identified, so that will be possible with even PMD also. So before going to start it, so I wanna show you, this is my PMD rule set file. Okay, so first we'll start with how PMD rule set will be configured. So as we know how PMD will be enabled for Maven, so we have a plugin called Maven PMD plugin, and for that we have to give a target JDK, and this is the rule set file which I am going to configure for my project, and I am giving execution phase as a test. So after execution of test, these are the goals will be identified and verified by PMD. Okay, so this is the my rule set XML, right? This is the property I am giving, and if we go and see, this is the PMD config URL where exactly I have configured all my rules. So don't get confused, we know already. So in PMD we have extra rule called CPD, which is totally different from other rules which are available in PMD. So CPD is nothing but copy paste detector. So if we have any lines of code, common code will be identified by CPD, and it will give warning saying like same lines of code is get copied. Please try to create a method and try to utilize the code. So obviously, right, increasing number of files, increasing number of lines in a code, it's not at all advisable, and it will create many more issues. Major problem we can say is a Java memory issue. Okay, so I don't want to discuss about in detail about that. So this is my configure file. So we'll go and see how configuration file, nothing but rule set file for PMD. Okay, so what name I gave, cpd.xml. So you can see, right, this is available in softwares PMD, it is cpd.xml. So these are the rules. Okay, so I have we'll try to understand. So we have an unused code, so in that I am trying to exclude a rule called unused local variable. This is, I want to show you an example how this will work out, so that's why I have excluded. But this is not at all advisable to exclude, because unused local variables needs to be detected. And we have a set of rules from string, so I am including all the rules which are available in string. So this is unused code, we have unused private variables. So this is import statements, if we have a duplicate imports need to be detected, and unnecessary conversion, temporary, and we have a basic HTML, basic XML which we are throwing empty cache block if something is there. and this is codesize.xml. For example, if we have a cyclomatic complexity, so nothing but if we have a, if blocks more than 5 times, and that can be treated as a cyclomatic complexity, and we are giving a level for only 5, so more than that it will be thrown by PMD. And one more rule we are excluding from braces is while loops must use braces. So these are the rules we are excluding and including. Okay, everyone will get doubt, right? Here we have a 2 doubts. So keep in mind, how I will know these are the rules are available in PMD, and how PMD rule set is not available, which file can be executed. Okay, first point I can answer. So I have to know rule set and which location it is available, Java, and how will I know unused code .xml, and in that how will I know these are the rules are available in unused code. So unused code means we have many things, right? Here itself if you see unused local variable and unused private fields, so here itself we can get to know. So something like we have in a PMD jar. So if you go and extract that PMD jar, so artifact and group ID are PMD. So if you extract it, you will get to know what in the rule sets are available. Actually in Maven 2, we don't have this location Java. Now in Maven 3 they added, because they have separate